Yes,
Okay.
Hocam.
Thank you, Mine Hocam. So, dear students and members of Faculty of Architecture and Design, welcome to the fourth session of ArchiDesign Talk Series. For today's talk, I would like to welcome one of our distinguished colleagues and a friend, Cüneyt Bükülmez, to give his seminar titled as Design Alternatives for Different Concepts in Gastronomic Spaces. Before leaving the floor to Cüneyt Bükülmez, I want to introduce him and his works briefly. So, Cüneyt Bükülmez received his undergraduate and graduate degrees from Department of Architecture of Istanbul Technical University, and he still continues his doctoral studies in the same institution. He co-founded the architectural firm Atelier 4N Architecture at 2004. He is very active on the professional practices since 2003. He designed, completed the application projects, and conducted construction site follow-ups of over 120 architectural and interior architectural projects in Turkey and and abroad. He has a very rich portfolio of completed projects, including luxury dwellings, ultra-luxury resort design, hospitality projects, offices and bank branches, industrial projects, industrial interiors, maybe let me say, gastronomic interiors, entertainment interiors, stand designs, contemplation spaces, shopping centers, and retail retail interiors of famous brands. Today's presentation will cover his recent projects in Maldives, Muravando, and Bodu Fushi, if I'm not mistaken, these two regions. Thank you. So these in these two regions, two ultra-luxury resort designs and application projects with construction areas of approximately 25,000 square meters. So, thanks to Cüneyt Bükülmez, we have now a chance to look at gastronomic spaces from a professional professional perspective, and we are grateful to him for making time for us. So now I leave the floor to Cüneyt Bükülmez. Dear Cüneyt, the microphone is yours.
Okay. Thank you, Sezin Hocam. Thank you for all to all of you to give me this opportunity and share all this valuable data, I think, from my side to all students and my colleagues and everybody. And I have just returned on Friday from the site. So just I was thinking how to cover up all these, but I think I will make a quick Instagram show up like a presentation after the main kitchen and the gastronomic spaces presentations. So just quickly jumping up to the first stage, which was Muravando Joali. You can check from the internet. It was opened in 2018, 75 luxurious villas. And right now we have five different cuisines in this compound. And mostly I will go into the details of this compound. And this year, according to some guest feedbacks, comments, and extra needs, we added extra spaces of gastronomical areas. And I will quickly explain in detail of the stages, or construction stages, material stages. So it will be a very interesting experience for you from a different continent in the middle of an ocean, plus using materials and textures and how we are influenced by environment and other techniques as well. So here we have two restaurants. Actually, in the beginning we had a bar area and a restaurant area. Generally in the hospitality we have an all-day dining experiences, so you can have all lunch and afternoon snacks and evening drinks in this type of an area, or you have a big restaurant of different cuisines and also serving a big kitchen behind. So here we have 75 villas. Everybody has its own garden and all facilities facing to the boat oversea. We have 50 on land, on beach. We have 24 villas. And the other Bodufushi was our second project. It was again, while I was preparing this, it was ongoing, but now open on 15th of November, and we are now already, I will just update these images at the end of the presentation. So we have a very colorful and interesting tropical images for you. And I am going to jump in some small from a different scales of kitchens and gastronomical spaces. We had a small bistro before with Kocacıklıoğlu Mimarlık together. It was in Galata, but now it's closed. It was just a small size kitchen behind, as you can see, and maybe 10 seats inside, like a bistro. We had a historical building, just converted into a very small kitchen where they can serve small lunch breaks. And it was serving as a patisserie in the front line. And when we check another one, that was a Maya, it's already closed also. It was again in Galata, Karaköy, I think. Again, a different techniques and different textures were used in this restaurant as well. For example, in this area, there is a problem of acoustics. So we use a wall of walnuts as a texture, as a material to break the sound on a perpendicular and a long wall. So the acoustic was cut by the help of a ceiling panel, as you can see on the left picture, and a wall of walnuts. So that was a beginning of a design point to break the acoustics, actually. But after this idea transformed itself to create the volume up as a wall. So sometimes a problem can revert itself as a part of a design or a element of a design easily. Let's quickly jump to a kitchen as a function. So you know the kitchen is the heart of the house, actually. Normally we cook, we eat, we have the energy, and we have all our daily routine by means of kitchen. And that's all used, and the element is fire, as you all know. So it's always hot. So we have to take care of many consequences and many elements. So generally, the fundamentals are vital consideration when designing kitchen floors is the actions which need to be considered. The most important thing is, when you consider for a public space, it's the hygiene and minimize the waste. That's also in relation with storage and area, and optimize the costs, including labor as well, and deliver the best possible result in the shortest period. So that is all related with your functional flow in the kitchen. And simply to be able to control the efficiently and on multiple levels. So in a you will see in slides, we are going to study a big scales of kitchens, and you will experience different functions interconnected with each other. So there is always a flow of human body inside, plus food, plus materials and everything. So in this busy traffic, we have to design it accordingly according to the needs actually, because generally there is a normal way of flowing in the kitchen, but actually sometimes generally here is the chef or the owner, they come up with different needs, so we have to solve this problem accordingly. And how does this flow begins? Generally, raw food produce travels into the kitchen through a receiving and then into a production stage. Then preparation begins and we complete ready for sale, mise en place. You hear it in this too much, maybe, you know, from the TV series and everywhere. Sending food to the guest, that takes a lot of time. And at this time, you lose a lot of heat. Return from sale, guest, which can be the garbage, dirty place, glassware, solid soiled linen, and removing of these waste. So this flow always goes through every morning, from morning until evening, or according to your working time. As we said, hygiene is the most critical point here, because from entrance to the outside of the compound, let me say, when you take the thing from market and put it into the kitchen and then you serve it to the guest, there is a part of a flow that always has to be in hygiene. And also we have to consider that we go inside of this area as a human body, so we have to take care of the hygiene as well. So according to this, there is a systematical food safety system which is called HACCP. So according to this system, there are some rules you have to obey, and according to these rules, we create our service kitchens and everything. So and this is also started from NASA, because when astronauts go to the space for explore, if they become ill from food poisoning, then there will be no hospital around. So demand was 100% safe food, which was unrealistic, but there is a process and condition can be optimized, and according to these rules also passed to the all gastronomic areas, and then now we are all using these rules on all areas. And after pandemic, you know, we all in now living in a different world right now. Reduction of the labor force in the kitchen, reducing cleaning by simple removal of obsolete kitchen design and layout. So there will be maybe we don't know, no tabletops on stoves or gaps underneath. So we need to be in a different set of knowledge maybe to help this purpose and the requirement of kitchen floors before new designs appear. So this is now a different talk is going on. But from a hospitality point of view, we are experiencing last 2 years in Maldives, especially. These are islands in the middle of ocean. So in a point of view, when you consider they are the most safest places on earth, you are all separated from people, everything, any illness or those type of things. So here, everything works the opposite of the world right now. Everybody come there for a safe holiday. They have their own villas, and just it's a protected zone. And in the things I will going to explain, it worked the opposite. And obviously now the technology is in a different position when we consider the kitchen. So after 2000, all the cooking methods, all the equipments, everything changed in a different position. As you can see from the books which I shared previously, These explain different types of cookings, using of different techniques and styles, and everything shifted in a modernist way. So we have to consider different types of techniques in kitchen. That means we need space for the kitchen, for these equipments, for a fire, for different gases they now use for desserts and everything, and maybe sometimes a type of kitchen that has to be separated. I will show in one example. We have totally separated vegan kitchen and the fish kitchen and the other kitchen, totally separated from each other, not to touch any type of material in between. So this is like a example of an industrial kitchen. I have previously shared the book. They wrote the book in this laboratory, actually. I cannot tell that it is a kitchen. So maybe if you are looking for a modern kitchen, that will look like something like this. You will need most of these type of equipments. Lastly, I had a chat with the chef. I was before I left, and I asked to him, if we do a new project together, what would you need from me as a kitchen? I asked. He said, just a space for all modern equipments and everything I can settle in, so I can serve everything, he said. But the flow behind always works the same. So you have the dirty dishes, preparations, as you see, and everything in has to be in order to serve the needs of the kitchen. So after this preparation and everything, that there is a guest front of house, we call. Generally, you can hear from me back of house and the front of house. That means back of house serves all these functional areas, and front of house refers to where the guest areas are designed or settled in hospitality areas. Generally, if we consider a kitchen, normally it's one space. And it has some stages, as I said in Hasib. Can you hear me?
Yes, yes, we can hear you.
Okay, bueno. So generally, a cooking station is the heart of the kitchen, and cleaning station, as we see on the behind, this side. And the preparation setup and the dishes and everything, and it goes to the guest area. What you see here is very interesting. Kitchen has to be always tidy, clean, and ready for service every time. So in the morning you come here like this, and in the evening when you leave, you have to clean and leave it like it is for the next day. So every day there is all a circular functional setup that has to give this function to feed this function. That means we have to be functional in the kitchen to clean it easily, to store it easily, because when you are rushing for 100 people giving the same order, so you have to prepare on this table 100 dishes at the same time. So that is a crucial thing in kitchen, to be more functional, and that has to serve the needs. This is cooking area with all fans and everything. Behind is the preparation area, as you see. So this is on the left is again extension of cooking areas. And what we see again here, I just want you to concentrate on the tidiness of the kitchen, actually, that has to serve all the functions. And when we jump in the front of us, nobody is too much related on the back of us. They just wait for their orders and they ask why it's too late, why it's something like that. So here the designer is failed. If the designer is failed in the kitchen, so you have a back always a late service, because that means it's not functioning on the back of us. And this is another type of a service in the front of house, on the guest side of you. So you now this is more popular, and guests are in relation with the deepness of the area and the volume. That means we can see the back of house, the kitchen, I mean. So you can get into relation with back of house quickly. So while you are having your service, on the back of house, people are working, preparing, and everything. So this also brings another design aspect, that you have to design total all elements of design aspects accordingly, because there is a field, a depth of field. So you have to design all the vertical elements and the other ones, and what you see, what you want to see, how you want to connect the spaces. So we have to think accordingly. Here, as you see, everything has to be tidy. Even the materials, the tools you are using has to serve according to your design. Always rushing, busy stages, as I said, even if it is in the front of house or in the back of house, a lot of people are always rushing in the kitchen. So as we all know from master classes, so we are more familiar with the systems. All goes on in the back of house as a different functions as well. If you are making a meat restaurant serving meat, you have to ask for their requirements, what they need, how they cook. Maybe you will need a big tool to create the meal. So we have to design according to these type of different elements that will be used in the kitchen. Or again, if there is a grill needed, that needs a lot of strong fan to take all. And if you want to showcase this unit, that you have to use maybe sometimes a glass, because they don't want to smell meat in the middle of their anniversary dinner. So we have to think of all these aspects when you are opening the kitchen to the front of house guest view as well. Or we can use different design elements to separate the kitchen. Maybe we create a see-through aspect from those. And these also differ from a different type of setups in the front of our guest areas, according to our concept or what we want to achieve on the front line. These are small elements. Maybe you have heard El Bulli, he was an example on the edge. Now also he's changing his concept just to a university-like unit. He was just beginning from this type of a idea to a laboratory type of searching for materials and the tastes, everything. He became one of the greatest chefs on Earth. And then again, as I said, now the kitchen is shifted on a laboratory-like uses and different experiences. Guests always look for really different experiences. And the previous picture converted into a backside of a big kitchen, industrial and very interesting modern kitchen, and they serve just, but the front, they keep as it is the same, and then all the units they serve the food were all designed by them and become the one of the famous restaurants with three Michelin star. From from unit to all kitchen things, what they use, they design everything. So you have to be in the package of all design elements. You have to consider all of things on the table, from linen to dish, and that you have to all consider these elements. So all these types are a design aspects, design items that you put into and make it a whole experience for the guest. This is another image from their kitchen. So kitchen set always visual like this. Okay, so the concept to remember, keywords: joy, warm texture, inviting, timeless. That those were our inspiration points for Ali Bey restaurant. Now we are shifting to a big hotel in Antalya. This is 450 rooms of kitchen. Backside, this part is the total kitchen area, and this is the serving area. As I said, according to Hasip, there is the service entrance, food goes in. This is the beginning of hygiene area. From this point, you have to clean and then go inside. And this part is totally the clean area. And for the service area, we serve the food in this open buffet area. And dirty plates go from inside, from the left. So there is always a counterclockwise working like this. Food goes in storage areas, and they are prepared and then cooked in the heart of the center, where we see in the pictures, the cooking stations. And then this is when it is prepared. It's ready for serving for the guest. And after all the dirty things collected from the guest, and then they go inside. So this is a dishwashing area. When it is washed and the clean table, clean, everything is stored here. So as you can see, there is always this circular flow in a main kitchen. So when it is apart from scale, when you consider a layout, that has to always mostly have this, you have to consider this flow as well. So a little bit closer look. So this is the dishwashing and entrance. Generally, we have some storage areas that has to be keep apart, like meat, chicken, and cold berries, and vegetables, and different zones for different units. Like you need to prepare the chicken and the fish and the meat in a different zones. According to Hasip rules. And this is generally the cooking station, so where there is the old fire goes on. And this differs according to what you cook. And these elements also, which you use big units, are washed in a separate zone than this one. So you have another zone of cleaning of your dirty goods, where you use in this hot kitchen, we call here. So this part is the cold kitchen as a preparation. This is called as a hot kitchen. And all the dirties go into washing area, and the all the garbage goes out from this area as well. So this is the Hasip border, and this is the Hasip border of the kitchen. So from this point, you cannot enter from another point. So this is a golden rule. You have to go from one point and service from one point as well. If you don't have this opportunity in a small layout, I will show you. So you have to keep the same rule for entering in and out as a Hasip rule as well. So you have to clean yourself while coming from outside, both the food and yourself. So this is where we have seen on the layout. So this is the entrance of food and the taken out of the garbage. So this is all where they taken is the preparation of the foods, and then these are the storage rooms. We keep in plus four or minus 10 according to their preparation phases. We keep in our storage rooms. As I said, this is a big kitchen for 150 rooms. This kitchen can easily serve 1,500 people at the same time. This scale. So this is a meat preparation room where you can understand from the red in the case to meat preparation. And for the breakfasts, again, different preparation zones. This is again, all preparation zone. So always when you see a kitchen, you have to consider the cleaning of it quickly and drainage and all the water and electricity needs from the walls and everything. So this is the bakery, another heart of the kitchen. Generally in hospitality, we keep the bakery apart from main system.
I think we have a delay in the views and now we are seeing the bakery part. So there is a little bit delay between the visual and your talk.
Okay. Let me wait a little. Now you see the dessert.
Yes.
Okay. Are we in the same point with the ovens right now?
Yes.
Okay.
Yes, now it's okay.
So this is the heart of the kitchen, as I stated. So everything puts here as a big kitchen. A little slower. As I said, these units are washed in a separate zone. We call it a different washing area for the hot kitchen. So this is the entrance door or outside door to the service area. And these are all the service zones for cold plates and hot plates behind. Service area. So you can consider this as a dining area as well. Normally, if you are creating mise en place to the table, but this is another also open buffet restaurant. So they serve for the guests as well. And about gram, as I said previously, we had a very, very small, like 60 square meters of an area. On the left side, this was only the kitchen. So we have only one entrance, a small area, and preparation, washing zone, and cooking zone. So the zones are same according to your layout, and a little bit preparation on, yes, storage and preparation. Sorry, the washing area was here. So this is a little bit storage and preparation. So according to your layout, sometimes you have to design accordingly, because now that since this was very, very small area, just this part was the kitchen totally. After it became something like this, all the elements and everything are used according to serve this small area. And all the gram form are used in the design on all ceilings and other things. So this was the starting point of design. And we use these elements from wood and make again to help also the acoustics. When you have a problem in acoustics, if you have a different levels and different materials in different heights, that will help you a lot for the acoustics. Just a small reminder. And again, as you see, one person can use this stage for preparing. Only there was a beautiful aga oven as a showcase unit. They were cooking everything in that oven. It's a very old, different type of oven. Backside was just only for preparation. So this oven was the our heart of design, as old one. So they just want to share this unit with the guest from the beginning. So this was the unit. And then after, maybe in a mall or something, the principle goes on the same. There is a preparation desk, cooking desk, and people take, maybe just use for a takeaway. They come and have their order and take away. But the circulation goes on the same. It goes always, follows the same principle. And this is for serving corner, cook preparation, cooking, and serving. Maya was again a challenge in the backside. The only this empty stage was a kitchen of it, and the front line was a serving area. So here in the beginning was just without some ideal positioning or in a design stage. So we had small touch-ups on this area and lift all the mood and feeling in a different level. So after some time, this cozy environment brought many guests, and also by the help of a strong cuisine as well. Again, as I said, from this point to that point, brings the mood in a different level by using design. It was something like that before, and then we just heat it up a little bit. And also here, you see a big table in the center. I prepared another one for you as well. So you have to consider the flexibility of front of house always, because sometimes they ask for two groups of 10 people, and they want to celebrate maybe an anniversary or a wedding or just something. So you have to make a setup for two big tables or one big table in the center, or without interrupting other guests. You have to always be functional. So there are some dimensions you have to obey in between seatings and everything. So when you multiply this as one unit set up your seating accordingly in a functional way, that will help using of the restaurant in always different options. So because always there is a need for this table. Sometimes they come, mostly. So if you design big tables, something like that, so you cannot move when they come. So you have to be optimal for dimensions. You have to obey the rules. You can easily do these maneuvers. Plus, you have to consider you leave a restaurant after 10 o'clock or 11 o'clock. And then this staff has to clean this area and prepare for the next day. So you have to be functional for them as well to carry these around and clean everywhere, clean all the tables and everything. That will also help for the staff. If you consider you are doing this every day, every night, late at night, after a busy service night, that will tire them a lot. So we have to be thinking of these. And also when you look around, check for every material. This about the walnut wall, we were just taking these materials from Karaköy, Perşembe Pazarı, and cleaning these and filling these, and these walnuts were just not used walnuts, and it was very cheap, but not more than 300-400 kilos of walnut we need to find. So in your design, you have to think and look around wisely and reasonable prices in material wise. You have to be creative about everything using, because I will show you some examples from Ireland also. All we need to look from local sources as well. That would also give a lot of advantage when you consider the budget. This was the one of the acoustic panel we set up in the center. And this was the old kitchen of the backside. It was very tight. Everything cooking, this area is cooking, this area was preparation and mise en place area. So sometimes you come up with these difficulties, but they were just easily serving up to 100 people from this area. And this was the cooking, dishwashing area and storage area on the behind. And always you have to consider extra spaces for storage, electrical units, and other things that will come from owner and chef. So this was only the entrance, as I said. So the Hasip rules begin from here. So they have to be all cleaning everything from this point. Open kitchen is another example, as I said. This is all interconnected with guest area. So everything goes on here, can be seen by the guest. This has advantages and disadvantages, because you need to deal with acoustics and ventilation and also the order on the backside. Sometimes terror goes on the back of house in the kitchen, and you have to take care of everything. But as an area, you are having a beautiful open space where you can design everything in accordance with your front of house and back of house. So this is another option for a designer. So as you see, this part is totally open from this is from a South African restaurant. Okay, we are now jumping to tropicals a little bit. So this is one of our Wandu restaurant from the first island. I will quickly show the renderings and then quickly jump to the pictures and also the stages. I was there for more than 4 months. And in I was all checking all the details, and some constructions were on stage. So I'm trying to explain. I will try to explain those details to you, where we had this one and where we end up. So you can see all the stages, design stages and the build stages. That will, I think, create maybe some questions from your side, and I can share all these with you because I was just having all these pictures and everything while I was there. So this is an Italian restaurant, renders of it. I will quickly pass these. So from design point, Otoban and we were all in-house. The interior and the exterior was just, since it was too much intertwined, in many parts we work in together collaboration. The all interiors are from Otoban, and the volumes from our side. These are the renderings. I quickly pass these. This is the serving area for morning breakfasts and everything. I have the pictures of it. So these are different serving areas. Here the idea was, this is the cold station, and here the rest I will come to pictures quickly. I'm waiting a little bit. Is there any delay now? I am seeing three coconuts with roofs.
So we're seeing trees, palm trees, an outside view. Moment.
Same place.
Okay.
Changed. Bellini bar again. And this year, these areas, you will see from the photos, these are the roof of different spaces of seating areas. Since this area is a very tropical zone, owner requested us to extend these roofs over these terraces. So now from the pictures, you are going to see that we have extended the roof over these terraces, because the interior seating was not enough for the guest space. There are some moments if all the rooms are full and everybody is with their children and everything, the seating was not available for everybody. So we have extended these terraces all with roof. You are seeing one terrace here, another one here, another one here. So these are extended with a roof. I will show you in the pictures this year because of extra need. So sometimes the design is a evolving stage also in these type of big projects. You have to sometimes let something evolve in a different form or shape or extend or increase. You will see those type of examples in the next day. So these are the pictures of the entrance. You are seeing the picture from this side. So this is the cold room. This is a serving area. This is hot kitchen. And behind is the main kitchen we have. So these are different seating spaces. The idea here was to separate people, not to create a canteen-like big space, separate the zones and create different points and different views for the guests to experience every night. Maybe they come one night and sit here, and the other night they come and sit here, and the other night here on the terrace. So you have many options of views and seating varieties by this, because you only have one restaurant here. So every day you are coming and having the breakfast and evening dinner here. And another update we had is to add another restaurant. So they have another option to dine in a different experience. So this is the entrance to the area where you have the pool. These pictures indicate without extended roofed over terraces. So as you see, this is the open terrace and the buildings. So these again from the front line. So this is the cold room. As you see, this restaurant is totally open to environment. Here normally all year around it's 28 to 30 degrees. So there is no conditional position, but you have to take care of the rain. And there are rain curtains. When there is too much rain, we lift down all the curtains. But also, we have to take care of a humidity problem. There is always like 60 to 75% of humidity every day. So for the cold, we need to create a cold room, which is in an AC position, and keep all the cold snacks, salads, or other things in one room. So if you look from a design point, now you have to examine all the aspects of sometimes climate, humidity, guest needs, environmental needs. So these all give a different look and aspect according to your design. So that changes all your design, or you have to rule, you have to obey the rules of nature and respect and design accordingly. So we keep all the coals in the room, and they prepare and serve it for you. So this is the hot kitchen. And again, here, it's a bit on the back side, as you remember from the layout, but you can have a relation. And then now after, we have separated this glass also with abacus-like design elements in this front line. We tend to keep this view a little bit more on the back side. So we added another layer of design of abacus in the front. I will show you in the pictures. And also gardens were added in between of these all different zones to help have the area feel like more in a green zone or like in a forest. Also seating options may differ and levels may differ the view and the environment. You can use different levels or seating options, soft seatings, chairs, different setups. So in one roof, under one roof, we can come up with different options as well. So this is also serving area of the back side. When there is materials, it's from something like this to change something to this. So these are also in villa dining. So we can also serve in the villa. Again, maybe this is just for one family. So again, as I said, you have to be functional while making the setup. Sometimes a group comes up and then changes everything in orientation and seating positions. Nighttime and the light. This is the most critical thing in gastronomical spaces, and the most, how can I say, you have to take care of every light in the environment, especially if there is no light on the table. This is a big area. We use table lights here. Guests cannot interact with the food, even if the quality is so high or something. You have to use the light wisely, and it has to serve the needs on the table. Actually, I will show you some. You see the difference of light on the table. Now this is a photographical scene, and how it is felt on the same table. So the effect of light on the table actually is very crucial. Generally, very low angle spots are the most important units to light the table from high point, because you need to orient the guest to the table and this scene. This is a quick layout. Again, the same functions goes on here. The food goes in, preparations and washing area. Dirties come from here. Food goes out from here and reach the places. Cooking station here, preparation, bakery, and WCs. Always consider the WCs, it's crucial. And cold room, winery was here and shifted to here in this garden after. So these are the terraces extensions to the sea. Here is the sea. a little bit look, closer look to the seating setup and kitchen. Again, this is the flow, as you see. There is always a circular flow that that shouldn't interrupt the heavy traffic. So this is the dishwashing, hot, storage, all the cold storage and preparations, and bakery, as I said. A little bit more closer. This is the heart of kitchen, where that is the open kitchen. This is around 75 square meters, serving 150 people. And backside is around 400 square meters. And this covers around 400 square meters of a kitchen. Again, this is serving 200 people at the same time. This is a little bit more closer room. In the hotels, generally there is another part which is apart from kitchen, which is called room service. In the middle of the night, you may feel like hungry and order for a club sandwich or a soup maybe. So the order is taken from here. Kitchen is always 7:24 open in hotels. So the room service reaches you and finishes your hunger. So this area always works for you. In hotels generally, you have to consider a good area for the room service according to your needs in the hotel. So this is again a big portion of the kitchen layout. I will show you a picture after. You have to prepare all the drawings in accordance with everything. So this is a layout for materials used on the floor. This is a floor layout. So you have to define everything in a different layers and in different sheets to help the needs and to explain this to the construction phase. And sometimes you are not there, and these are the languages of our needs that is transferred to the construction. So drawing is so important that everything is translated by means of these data. And if you don't give the needed details in drawings, that will not create the idea that you dreamed of in your design. And this is all about lighting details. And all these has to be prepared in connection and served to the construction site from you. And also you have to control these always. Because on site there is always different situations that has to be decision givers, and you have to control them, because apart from you, many people want to take decisions to do it in an easier way. So you have to be always in control on the site as well. So Saoke is from Hot Potato. Hot Potato, he was there, and then the Japanese interior architect. This is the entrance to the restaurant, again in the compound. He used bamboos and bottles of what was it? I don't know, in Japanese drink. I don't remember.
Sake.
Thank you, sake. And in the center, you are welcomed with a beautiful roof interior and a beautiful bar. So sometimes a design piece is your heart in the seating environment. So after you finish this beautiful corridor of fame of sake, you welcome with a beautiful bar. On the left, you see again an open kitchen setup. This is all glass. This is on the left side. You will see with the pictures here. So clean and neat, as I said, all things, plates are prepared for the service. And this is again an example of open kitchen. And different areas for seating options, like this was a cabana. Or this is an overwater restaurant by piles. We have different levels of decks. And this is the kitchen side and a view from that cabana. Yes, this is, you know, the effect of light you see now. This is a night view and this is a day view. So the light goes and changes everything in your volume. So you always consider light in a totally apart from everything in coordination with your design. Because light changes everything. You see it's daytime, something like that. And you can see the back of us and service jetties, but nighttime there is all pitch dark and you don't see anything. And menu and all, as I said, creation of the other units you use in the service are all related, may relate to your design as well. The table, the cutlery, and the light we use, as I said, in the table is totally oriented to the food, very strong. And this can be also strongly support your design as well. Cutlery again. And this is the layout. You walk in the Hall of Fame of Sake. This is a sushi bar, and you are welcome with a strong bar unit. And then seating in different levels and different units of cabanas. And where you sit, you can see the water as well. This is totally over water. Again, a little bit closer look. This serves like 60 person at the same time. And kitchen is, the heart of the hot kitchen is here. The cold preparation and dishwashing system is again here. As you see, the food goes out from here and the goods come from here, and technical and storage, preparation. Always the flow goes on same according to your needs. It's shrinked or extended. Again, a small cold room and preparation and hot kitchen. So there is another bar area, daily used for lunch, afternoons, or in the evening for a drink, or at night. So here we use water element around the unit, and just an area in connection with the pool. So these are the renders again. Quickly pass these from here to the come up with this solution, this end up. Interior was used all the soft colors and textures for sliding panels and everything. Again, here was all related with open air. But since we use the open air units, all these materials are rain and water resistant, and according to sun, UV protected colors and textures and everything, you have to consider the material of your design aspects according to where they are used. If they are in the open area, you have to take care of everything as material. Also, the best place for guests was these areas. We put a lot of chairs and everything, but they come always and sit under the trees where there is the nature strong as a feeling. So if there is a strong nature around you, use it very strong, because always a connection comes up with the guest throughout nature. So that is an always a usage element. If you cannot use it as a biophilic design, that means you mimic the nature with the textures, with the colors. You can take it, just a picture from here. I will show you from here. Or if you are experiencing any problem about how to come together with a color or with a texture and everything, just take a picture from here and then go with it. So you mimic the nature, yeah, and your design flows into a biophilic idea, because the texture people see, they feel immediately from the same view of this one as well. So these coconuts grew. Now I see this picture is a little bit from 2 years ago. And there are different options of seedings as well. And this is from up. And this is the, again, layout, hot kitchen, dishwashing, preparation, the same. It goes from here, inside entrance, and service out. After there is a need for a pizza, we quickly change this area to a pizza oven. So guests can see the oven, a beautiful oven. We just, sometimes you can showcase your unit. There are beautiful some kitchen instruments, like an oven, big oven. We showcased it, and now always at lunchtime they go for pizza and other things where they can use. So you have to be always open to all different options, because sometimes you want to serve a salad, but they come up with a need of pizza and something different. So always you have to be flexible sometimes, while adjusting the necessary spaces. So again, this is the hot area. Again, dishwashing and service options. You see the colors. Look back side and the front side. We try to mimic the nature. You can see the palette from here to here. A small ice cream shop in front. And this is from Japanese. You do these, and then one night they come up with a street food setup. So sometimes just a beach is a kitchen for service. So sometimes maybe they may ask for you to create a unit for something like that. But when you do it in an improper way, then it becomes like this, but I'm always trying to push them to come to a proper design. But as you can see, when they want to take some decisions, you have to push them from a design point. If you let them go, they come up with this type of solutions sometimes. Maybe when you come up with a beautiful design of something, like just a repeating idea or a very strong thing, it becomes in a different design aspect. These are different examples. Okay, now this flow is newly opened. I'm just going. This is another restaurant from the Bodufushi Island. This is the second island. This restaurant is actually, the hotel is all about well-being, not a normal, typical resort. Here you come for a retreat, maybe. Not openly alcohol is served. Everything is more healthier. There are many facilities for exercises, fitness, Pilates, and a very strong spa amenities and functions. So now, actually, after COVID, the idea of holiday or retreat is shifting in another level. So this is also reflecting to food sections as well, more healthier, and people want to know how you cook, where you cook, and also this extend to the volume. They want to experience a different environments. So here you have to always consider different options. So this is a again, these are renders. I will show you the pictures after quickly. And this stage, I will rewind back from this render and picture to how it is built, how these elements are formed. So this is like a temple-like area, interior setup, with three different cuisines, as I said. And this is a cold dining room. This area is totally open to environment. That means not non-AC. This room is an AC room only in the compound. Three different types of kitchens are separated from each other. Red indicates the healthy kitchen. Green indicates the vegan kitchen. And the blue that is here, you will see from the pictures, indicates the fish kitchen. So behind, you see a different three stages of kitchen. You can see the cooking and preparation process from here. And behind this tree, and this restaurant is also two-floor restaurant, ground floor is, but in design, we try to step down slowly, not to feel like we are in two-floor area. You come up with a small ramp. I will show you from the pictures. And then step down to the sea with different levels of seating. And behind is the another preparation kitchen. And downstairs is all the storages and everything. So the backside, these three kitchens you are going to see. And again, as we stated before, there is a cold room in the compound as well. So these were the rendering stages of the design. As I said, with different levels of seating, we are coming down to the beach, and there is a big idea of ocean flow on the roof, and inside is just different stages of temple-like units inside. And so this is the bar area, Mojo. Now they are named. This is the floor. So this is slowly leveled down to the beach and connected with the beach, and in connection with the all-day lounge area. We quickly share the stages of this floor with you right now, because right now. Here, can you see the pictures now?
Yes.
Very clearly.
Okay. So this is now 3-4 days ago's process from here. So as I said, we have a small. We played with elevations to reach in a half way, and then go with stairs inside. So this is the end. And process entrance area. I will, let me see if it is good, if we can go to layouts first. Let me jump to let me explain the layouts so that will be more easier. So these are the levels of seating and private AC room. We created this room for maybe some people who are not in a good relation with more humidity and tough conditions of weather sometimes, so they may need to stay in AC environment. So we created a room. So this is a construction stage. This is all steel. Concrete until this level it's concrete, after this level it's steel, and then after we cover with wooden design elements. I will show you all those stages to you. So these are all steel. The layout, different levels of seating outside, inside, and three hot kitchens, totally separated from each other. I will explain this now, some comments and feedbacks from chef right now. There is another chef before, and now he is just commenting on these. And here is again preparation, and from the stairs to down section, and cold room. These three kitchen service goes in and out, and again for the dirty dishes also comes out here. So this is the ground floor, big storages, offices, and these are some other functions, and a cooking class, bakery, again storages. This is a little bit a bigger area, so this layout is more bigger. Again, for a little bit close up, goods go inside, store, bakery, and here we use two elevators. We call them monchage, only service cars, service units go up. When it is ready, they use these elevators to go up to the second floor. I will show you the pictures. Okay, now I can pass to the images again. So this is the entrance area. This is the cold room. Now we are rewinding back from pictures quickly. This is the newest pictures. I'm going to rewind back so you can see the differences and the adding of materials quickly. Maybe you can have some questions about it, how it is made, how this is set up. So this is the main entrance with the buggy and the cars. They stop here, let the guests in, and they walk in, and they are welcome with this view. Go inside. From the other side, you walk up, and again the frames and the textures and the color palettes, always you have to consider these. And again, interior and the views from far. Yes, this is the different levels that I explained in the renderings. So you walk down to the beach. Also in the beach side, generally, I'm looking for the pictures here. From here, you can go to beach and sit by the beach as well. Also, there is an option to go down until the beach. Yeah, here under the trees. They always tend to come and sit here. They leave the building always with nature. That is the most strongest point. And nighttime, the use of light again. As I said, the only small unit, how you see the effect of the light on the tables. And the counters. This is the most problematic unit in gastronomic design. You have to create a beautiful counters where you hide the cutlery and everything inside, or this post unit, things and that. This is the most critical unit of restaurant. They will always ask for a service unit. You have to position them according to the tables, which is very crucial. Welcome desk, and the guest is welcome, and different seating options, and the light to the table. Pictures are a little bit blurry, and this is cold station, cold area. Cold room, let me say. Interiors. Yes, this is the healthy kitchen, vegan, and the fish on the other side. Let me see. Again, blurry. Yes, the light. I go quickly. Tables, lights, cutlery, colors, textures. Yes, this is the fish on the left side, and this is the cauldron. And you see the clean and the materials all are different in every part. And the food is always now transferred in a different levels in these areas. Again, a big table is needed sometimes, and they change every all the setup. Everywhere this is needed. I just took this picture to show you. They just make this organization everywhere. Again, fish area. So you have a warm relation with the kitchen here. So hot kitchen is separated according to the function of it. They cook fish here only. The other one is totally vegan. Nothing is crossing each other. The disadvantage of this, according to chef feedback, they cannot communicate together in the area in between, because you have to place the order at the same time. If I order fish and my friend orders a vegetable dish, they have to come at the same time. But since they cannot communicate because of the walls, they said we need to open these walls and see each other. So always there is feedback coming out. Now we are rewinding back. You see the lights and cutlery are gone. I am quickly going back. Contains. So tables are gone. We are rewinding back. So you can see the lights were not there, so they used for the opening a different lights, and the lights changed after. So tables are gone. I'm going back quickly. Yes, landscape is on. Lights here are now there. They are checking the lights, intensity, color. The color of the light, always you have to take care of it. 3,000, 2,700, 4,000. You have to see the Kelvin effects on your volume. So this is more whiter in a different level. So now we are going back to construction stages. Quickly. As you see, the heavens are coming from these stages. Marbles going on. Now you will see that there was a need of light quickly, and we created a linear light at this stage. It was not on the design. In design, the light was here. But this element was blocking totally the light. So we switched the light on this level after we set them to do it here, and they did it here. So you have to control everything outside, and they shifted here. And then we have the light in that position. Roofs, yeah. But and now these elements of wood, every piece is separately put by the workers here. Now we have all the infrastructure first, and then interior, all these elements one by one. It's like a crazy one. They got crazy. Still works. And you see only the infrastructure now, and tiles in the kitchen. Textures, tiles, kitchen, serving. Cooking class section. And when you send this 4 meters of an element to an overseas area, there is a big risk of breaking it, and this part is broken, and we have to order it again, but they cut it, make it here. So you have to design according to the dimensions or how you are. You have to check if you can send in container or that, something like that. Great. You see these all materials are on the facades, are replacing one by one. Now you can see the infrastructure still. All tiles on the kitchen. Old kitchen. And these are hacking board we use. We imitated wood with a board element. There is a wood texture over it where you cannot understand if it is wood or not. It seems like this. So you have to check different material options. Sometimes you can imitate some materials. And you see we rewind back, all the texture is gone. It's here ready to come. And back to construction site, and marble is going on. So it takes like from here, I think it's June to November, from this look to that. You have to take care of every bit of detail and from beginning to the end. I can quickly, now it's 8 o'clock. I can go on, or how do we do?
If we stop somewhere here, but you may want to conclude in a way, and we may have some questions from our students. Most probably they are interested and having questions at the moment, so may pause for a moment and ask for their comments and questions.
Okay. Actually, one building remaining quickly. I can quickly wrap up this and then we can jump to the questions. So this is next building to the restaurant. They all have the lounge here with the pool, in connection with the pool. I quickly pass the renderings. So we have the lunches here and seatings. I just pass quickly the renders so you can see from where the design takes and how we can achieve on site. So this is a tea lounge. They are bringing different types of teas and just a tea wall, let me say, different types dedicated for tea, this unit. And there is a healthy bar on the back side. Three unit refers one for seating, one for tea, one for bar, and we use the sand underneath. So this is the layout, the entrance and the seating options. They are all connected to each other by means of roof. And there is a small kitchen again behind, a tea corner and a bar. Let me go closer. Again, a small hot kitchen, preparation and cleaning station. This is a picture from old times. Yes, this is the restaurant and the bar area. This is one of the latest now. They're all covered up. Water in the pool, restaurant, and mojo. Okay, let me quickly share the photos of it. Just to give an idea of the space right now. So we are now in this situation. Again, I just want to direct focus you about the palettes and the color and the environment. The intention was to go according to this well-being, and weightlessness is the key. As a concept, to be more softer, is lighter in the colors and the design, not to be, and this is affected from all aspects used in units in the hotel as well, the green bicycles and everything, and the texture right now in connection with the design. So this is the main unit with textures. This is the seating option of the unit, the pool, Again, the idea was to level it down and reach the beach in always different elevations. The same idea in the restaurant follows here as well. That was in the terraces, here was in the water by means of different levels of water. So one was up, like you can go and sit inside. So this is the bar area. It's the view. And the seating, again, the colors and everything, seating options. And the tea bar, tea lounge. The restaurant is mixed here, sorry. Yes, the tea lounge. Again, nighttime. The light, effect of light. And bar area. Light. The pictures are very from again get together moments. They change all the seating and everything. An event. Now here is a storytelling event in the evening. So everything you have to be again flexible. Different seating options. And those connections in between three roofs with another roof. Tea ceremony area bar. Okay, these three, and now we are rewinding back. You see everything is going on, the seatings arrived, rewinding back. This picture is very interesting, that is 9:58 time, and this is 8:44. So it's like changing of paradise. You can create the paradise, but you have to be sure of what you are doing. So now we are rewinding back again. You have to cover and protect all of your materials. Rewinding back. All these people are crazy for marbles and bizatsas. Every this texture is coded and placed on the bar, so you have a continuous flow of an image on the bar. This again, the texture's gone. Now they are building infrastructure, roofs and everything. So before this is like, this is in June, yes, something like that. Infrastructure, the wood, concrete beams, wood structure, and they are connected with steel, many different materials used. Pool is going on, and as you see, it's construction is on. So the bar area, infrastructure, steel, the frames. I just want you to experience these from this point. After a couple of months, you come up with something, but here you have to always take care of every bit of detail. After your design, nothing ends. On site, you have to run for your dream, or else it comes up with very fatal errors or something like that. It's just a small reminder for these. For example, this material arrived to the site. The same tile as you see, this hexagonal one. And the guy asked me, are we going to tile it in this way or in this way? So in this tile, you can come up with a very difficult, different two solutions. You have to draw this way, this one, totally on the paper, because you just want this one, but they may end up with this one. So again, these are the textures and everything, but we are just experiencing and seeing around, and they're affected. You see, we are using separation elements, just they are on the trees, simulating. So this is all about biophilic as well. You mimic the nature in all this design. You try to, I mean, just try to look around in a different way. All will seem to you in a different position, like this is a coconut tree, for example, but if you go a little bit closer to this one, like here, maybe you can see all these colors and textures in a different way. So you can create your palette in any part of it. You can see all around with the connections of the colors and everything, or this beautiful flower of that tree. This is all about proportions and connections and flow. So the nature is everywhere, and the colors of blue or the orientation of things we just use. And that was all right now. There is more, but for this one, actually, if you ask for a layout, I was just sharing for the planting of these trees, we use this layout, just these for references for the guys, and they after this layout, they come up. You see this on the wall, and they are doing with these guys, and they come up with this. Actually, everything you can see and do there in a different manner, I can say. So I stop here. And also, I can give a more from that kitchen pictures. I can quickly share for the last things, just to give an idea. These are again from preparations inside. You see how clean and neat it has to be, and one big problem here, I just want to mention these. I stop in the elevator. These are Monchage connected elevators. Just only service cars goes in, and then service comes from down. And there are all protected parts. While they are running the cars around inside, in order not to break the corners and sides, you have to take care of corridors. And a corridor has to be at least 150, 140 minimum to have a proper circulation. This is bakery downstairs. Preparation storage rooms from the kitchen. This one. There is an AC unit here. This is the service counter. The food comes here, and the waiter comes and takes the food and goes away, brings it to the table. This AC flows down to the food, and food gets cold. Even this counter is hot. So now the chef is complaining me about how to find the solution of this one. So you have to take care of every bit of detail, from AC units, mechanical units, electrical units, to everywhere in kitchen. Because this little detail, flowing the cold air to down, makes the food cold. So this is our biggest problem in our kitchen right now. So every bit of detail is so crucial in kitchen. You have to coordinate many disciplines to work in harmony. These are from, and also separate a lot of areas, spaces for technical units such as electrical panels, network units, computer areas, storage areas, cleaning gadgets, something like that. So I stop here. I can go on, but I'll be happy to answer your questions.
Yeah, maybe it's time to have some questions from the students. Time is never enough for such beautiful projects to talk about these projects and going into detail about all of these spaces and all of the ideas that you had in mind. Yes, we have a little bit of a problem acoustically, I think that, yes. I'm hearing my own voice, but now it's going to be solved, I think. Yes, I think it's okay. Thank you very much. Thank you very much for the earphones. So I was saying, we're really very happy to see your beautiful projects. Time is never enough for talking about seeing the talking about these projects and going into detail of these projects, but on behalf of our students and faculty members, I would very much like to thank to you due to this very interesting and inspiring presentation of yours. Dear Cüneyt Bükülmez, I would like to see whether our students have questions or not. Maybe I'm looking at the participants list at the moment. Dear students, maybe you can have, you can make some comments or you can ask some questions to Dear Cüneyt Bükülmez about the projects or something in general about the gastronomic interiors or gastronomic spaces or the constructions that we have seen in detail on the island. There are no questions at the moment. Maybe while waiting for them to pose some questions, I have a question to ask if it's okay. Maybe by that time, our students may warm up and ask a few questions to you. We understand that there are many aspects in the design of a gastronomic interior, especially the design of the kitchen. So the aspects that have impact on the design of the kitchen, the advanced kitchen we have, the type of food, the amount of people that you're serving, also the level of luxuriousness of the complex, and does also chef's comments change the design?
Every chef has a different way of working.
Maybe we cannot hear you. Maybe you can keep it a little bit higher, your microphone.
Can you hear me now?
Yes, now perfectly.
Okay.
Yeah.
Okay. Yes, you are right. Every chef has a different understanding way of working. And plus, in the beginning, as I try to state, if you are going to serve a different type of meat or different type of vegetable, equipments may change all of your design, or they may become the center of the design as well. So they can also guide or change your design or sit in the middle of your design.
Thank you.
Generally, right now, guest experience is shifting in a modern way. Last time I asked a question to the chef, as I said, what would you, if we are now designing a new kitchen, what would you ask for me? As I asked to the chef before I came, and he said, I need a modern kitchen. And I try to understand the meaning of what do you mean by modern, I ask. He said on the back of house, if we create a right flow and just an area for modern units to keep to work as a dimensionally functionally, that would be enough for me, he said. That was very interesting, because now things change in a modern way. You can use many equipments, and you have to check and speak with these guys, because they use very specific units, and they need a different type of different dimensions or spaces or different needs in the kitchen. So that will change all your design from the beginning, actually. The concept, as you said, the type of food, that changes everything totally.
Thank you. Thank you for the answer. So I'm once more looking at our students, whether they have a question or not. Dear students, you can also use the chat box and write down your questions if you have, or any comments, so that I can read to our guest if you have. Or maybe our faculty members would like to add comments or questions. Yes, a question coming from Sena Asrak. There is no question, but I thank you very much for this high quality project examples, drawings, and all conceptual explanations. That was very valuable presentation about design. So she says so. And Enes Yılmaz. Thank you very much. It was a very informative presentation for all of us. So they are making comments. Yes, thanks for the information. I don't have any questions. One of another student of ours has made a comment. So
One aspect we spoke together before. This image is very important for me. Here we are trying to finalize a design with many members of team. These people are from construction team, these from hotel team, these design owner here, architects and interior designers, everybody is here. The idea here is to communicate. The level of communication and relation and the responsibility of a designer. The conversation here we are talking is there is an art piece is forming up in front of this one. And the thing is, are we going to put it here or 50 centimeter on the right or 50 centimeter on the left? So the relation and the communication the designer has is like a sometimes a moderation of a problem or a moderation of a design. Here you have to take responsibility, ask questions, answer questions, and solve the problem. Everybody sometimes comes and look at you as the problem solver, because you act like or you are on the stage like a designer. So you have to come for answers, and that is the most crucial thing, is the communication there. That I just want to share this latest experience from my side. Really from design until you put it there, the communication never ends with owner, with the other teams, with everybody. That's very important for me.
Yeah. Thank you very much for especially highlighting the importance of communication between the designers, different groups of designers. So there may be interdisciplinary work going on, as we are seeing here. And also the communication between the client and the users of this space, whatever the space is yes. Very important. So thank you very much for highlighting that issue. And you also have highlighted many times the importance of the atmosphere, which is created by lighting materials, texture, different types of furniture and different furniture and space organization. So they were all very valuable for us, for our students. So I want to once more thank you for all of these beautiful projects that we are seeing and for valuable ideas in your designs, for sharing with us, for making time for us, dear Cüneyt Bükülmez. Now, I would like to give the microphone to Mine Hocam, our vice dean, because she has a few things to tell you as well. So, Mine Hocam, microphone is yours.
Thank you. Thank you. Cüneyt Bükülmez, thank you for this delicious presentation.
Thank you.
It's been great having you with us here. We have a little tradition here in ArchiDesign Talks. As Bahçeşehir University Faculty of Architecture and Design, we donate in our guest's name. So a donation has been made in your name to Sey Vakfı, helping underprivileged children for equality in education. Thank you so much for all your time and effort.
Thank you very much. Thank you. It was really a big honor for me to share all this because, you know, sharing is caring and caring everything this for all students. We have all experienced these and it's really valuable for me to share these with you because it's I hope they touch and they use it in their other design experiences. Thank you very much for your donation as well.
Thank you. Okay, good evening, everyone.
Thank you.
Thank you.